You might remember when the Liberals were here in Calgary in late January of this year for one of their cabinet retreats. The aim of that meeting was to talk about Trump as president, but who are we kidding here? The Liberals love to mix work with pleasure and on your dime. These things are more like all-inclusive luxury vacations, and you know how normal people will be careful with their choices if someone treats them to something? Like, say you're invited for dinner and you really want that prime rib, but you order the burger instead because you don't want to be rude and cost someone doing something really nice for you extra? Well, the Liberals just aren't like that. In fact, they're more the type to take advantage when the tab isn't on them. And I have the documents to show it, all 950 pages that they sent when the Rebel requested the information on how much the trip cost. I honestly can't go through every single expense in this package. It's almost 1,000 pages of receipts and tabs. But let's put this into perspective here. This was a meeting that the Liberal cabinet that includes 29 ministers attended. The Prime Minister was also there, along with who knows how many staff members. Like any trip that anyone goes on, the big items were airfare, food, and accommodation. So let's talk about the major expenses. I said that these retreats are more like luxury, all-inclusive vacations. Well, get this. The Liberals decided to host this thing at the poshest hotel in Calgary, the Fairmont Palliser, which is actually fit for a queen. She stayed the night in 1990 when she visited. Beautiful place right downtown, super fancy, oldest and most luxurious hotel in the city easily. This is the kind of place people go to have a really lavish high tea. The Prime Minister himself paid almost $190 a night, a cost that was said to be over the limit for the city of Calgary, for the government, but the Liberals care so much about your money that they booked it anyways. They also had all of their meals at the Palliser. Price tag for 3 days, over 17 grand. This included all meals and all breaks, so breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and two coffee breaks, plus the cost of renting the meeting room at a grand a day. That's groceries for 2 years for some families of four. And then, of course, there were the travel costs. Take a look at Lana Gauthier from the Privacy Council offices, airfare at $644.02, return from Ottawa. You know the Liberals like to bring an entourage with them anywhere they go, but consider the majority of them would have had to fly to the meeting. That would mean tens of thousands just on airfare alone. Actually, Gauthier's expense claim form gives us an idea of how much this thing costs per person. She rents a vehicle and takes a taxi for close to $300, pays over $140 for parking, valet of course, and her hotel bill over $750, close to the cost of a monthly mortgage for some. Her total expenses alone, almost $1,500. You could probably take your family on a pretty decent all-inclusive trip to an exotic destination for less than that per person. But there's a difference here. This was a government meeting, not a trip that someone booked with their own money. Not that many in Calgary would even be able to at this point, considering the city has been the hardest hit by the economic downturn in the country. And then there are the costs of the actual meeting, you know, the work they were apparently here doing. I mentioned that $1,000 fee per day for the room booking. But then there was the audio equipment that ran us for over 17 grand, and the Prime Minister booking his own office and a spot for a media event for over 1,200. And then there were the cargo fees for things like super secret classified documents for the retreat that cost over tens of thousands to send return from Ottawa. This cargo added up to over 35 grand just to ship. Unreal. We don't need to wonder how the Liberals are spending us into debt. Do you plan posh trips to fancy hotels when you can't afford it? Well, the Liberals do, and there's no doubt this one trip cost taxpayers hundreds of thousands of dollars. Those were just a few examples I gave you out of the hundreds of pages of expenses we received. They could have scheduled it in Ottawa, but the Liberals are simply too bored with the bubble. And the justification for spending so much on the trip? Take a look at this pre-authorization checklist for travel the Prime Minister must meet with his cabinet was the reason. Any cost-saving measures taken? Nope. This is the third retreat this government has had in 2 years, and instead of doing this when they're all in Ottawa to save costs, they have to hold these things across the country. Let's face it, we're not paying for the Liberals to work when they go on these trips for meetings. We're paying for them to go on holiday as one big happy family of 30, plus their entourage. For the Rebel.media, I'm Holly Nicholas. Thanks for watching. You won't find this kind of digging anywhere else, and that's why our censors want to shut us down. But Ezra has a plan. Please visit istandwiththerebel.com for all of the details and to show your support.